The Canadian soldiers stormed Juneau Beach on June 6, 1944, as a result of the attack planned by Major General R.F.L. Keller. There was five infantry divisions, two British who stormed Sword and Gold, two American infantry who stormed Omaha and Utah, and one Canadian who stormed Juneau.
Juneau Beach was 5 miles wide and was near Courcelles-sur-Mer, France. The Canadian water assault came from Portsmouth and landed on Juneau. The airborne assault came from London and landed near Caen.
The first wave of soldiers landed at 7:55 a.m. The second wave of soldiers arrived after from three different parts of the beach. The North Shore Regiment approached it from the left side. The Queen's Own Rifles approached it from the center, and the Regina Rifles landed on Courcelles-sur-Mer.
The Royal Winnipeg Rifles took the western edge. The Canadian Scottish Regiment secured the right flank, and the British Royal Marine Commando secured the left flank. While this was happening, the Germans were holding Juneau Beach with guns, wires, mines, and many other defense obstacles.
The Canadians overcame coastal defenses. They had to capture ground positions and defended against German counterattacks. The Canadians succeeded in their efforts in capturing Juneau Beach. Although it was a success, they suffered many casualties.
During the first 6 days of the Normandy campaign, 1,017 Canadians died. Altogether, 5,020 Canadians were killed in action. 156 Canadians were captured during the Juneau Beach campaign, including the 20 taken to Abbey Dardenne.
Abbey Dardenne is a place near Caen and was built in 1121. It had a mixture of medieval buildings, gardens, and a place of worship. During World War II, the 12th SS Panzer Division, led by Kurt Meyer, took up residence at the Abbey.
This was a very strategic decision because it was on an elevated piece of land, and when standing on top of the church, you could see for miles in every direction. They had a clear view of the Canadians on Juneau Beach.
Abbey Dardenne was home to a great Canadian tragedy. The 12th SS Panzer Division was led by Kurt Meyer. Kurt Meyer was a hardened, fanatical Nazi who supported Hitler's vision.
He was one of Hitler's elite bodyguards before becoming commander of the 12th SS Panzer Division. He fought in Poland, France, and Holland. He was accused of unspeakable behavior. He burned villages, murdered women, children, and many soldiers.
The entire 12th SS Panzer Division consists of boys aged 17 to 18, with the exception of officers and commanders. They were known as the Hitler Youth Division. The regiment was taught by the 1st SS Panzer Division, which were diehard Nazis.
POWs are prisoners of war. During the Juneau Beach movement, many Canadian POWs were taken. When capturing a POW, there are certain guidelines that have to be followed. Sadly, at one German concentration camp, the POWs were only fed two meatballs, a small bowl of grass cabbage soup, and one slice of bread per day.
The Geneva Convention dictates the rules of warfare. The guidelines are, they cannot take any of your personal possessions. You are not required to give them any other information other than your name, age, rank, and service number. You must give them shelter, food, and water, and execution of a prisoner is a war crime.
Usually, Canadian POWs were treated in accordance to the Geneva Convention, but at Abbey Dardenne, these guidelines were not followed. At Abbey Dardenne, 20 Canadian soldiers were shot and killed in the garden. These are the names of the fallen.
From the North Nova Scotia Highlanders, Private Ivan Crow, Private Charles Doucette, Corporal Joseph McIntyre, Private Reginald Keeping, and Private James Moss.
From the 27th Canadian Armored Regiment, Trooper James Bolt, Trooper George Gill, Trooper Thomas Henry, Trooper Roger Lockhead, Trooper Harold Phil, and Lieutenant Thomas Windsor.
Unknown Regiment Soldiers, Private Walter Doherty, Private Hollis McKeel, Private Hugh McDonald, Private George McNaughton, Private George Miller, Private Thomas Mont, and Private Raymond Moore. A boy and a mother lived in a farmhouse in the Abbey and fled once the war started. There were flowers growing all around the edges of the garden, and when they came back, they were everywhere. The family suspected something was wrong, so the boy dug a hole and found a dead Canadian soldier. 19 other bodies were discovered in the garden and around the back of the house.
The Hague was first established in 1899 by the governments all over the world. It is located in the Netherlands. In 2009, 109 countries were members. The Hague is a place where war crime trials take place. Kurt Meyer was tried here and was found guilty, but there wasn't sufficient evidence to put him in jail for life or execution.
Kurt Meyer served 8 years in the New Brunswick Penitentiary and was released on September 7, 1954. 7 years later, he died of a heart attack. The Vico family had lived in the Abbey grounds since 1920. In 1980, Major Ian J. Campbell was serving in Europe and visited the site with Jacques Vico. Also, R.L. Bennett, a professor at the University of Caen, came with them.
These three men decided to commemorate the fallen soldiers by making a plaque stationed in the garden. The plaque was made of scattered remains of the original abbey. The monument was built by master craftsmen Léon Garnier and Jean Mesnil. The monument was unveiled on the 40th anniversary of D-Day.
Inscribed on the plaque is, "On the nights of June 7th and 8th, 1944, 18 Canadian soldiers were murdered in this garden while being held here as prisoners of war. Two more prisoners died here or nearby on June 17th. They are dead but not forgotten."